हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। वेलकम टू द अनदर ऑनलाइन वीडियो ऑफ आरसी एजुकेशन हब बानसूर। लेट्स स्टार्ट क्लास 12 बायोलॉजी चैप्टर नंबर 9 एंजाइम्स। ओके, एंड टुडे लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट द अनदर टॉपिक स्पेसिफिक प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एंजाइम्स। बिफोर दैट वी वर डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एंजाइम्स एज वेल एज सिंपल इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द एंजाइम्स। ओके, सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू द टॉपिक specific properties of enzymes. So enzymes having the several properties that discuss one by one. First one, as we know that mostly enzymes are proteinaceous in nature, it means they are consist of protein. Okay, and protein and non-protein part both are responsible for the enzymatic activities. Okay, so this is the first specific properties of the enzyme. As they consist of protein, so they are specific or good for their enzymatic activities. Another property is specificity. So enzymes exhibit specificity for a particular type of reactions or for a group of reactions. Some enzymes can catalyze only a specific reactions, whereas some can catalyze more than one type of reactions. So this is the specificity, very important property of the enzyme. And specificity later on divided into the four major parts. First is absolute specificity. As the name suggests, absolute specificity, it means some enzymes can catalyze only a specific type of reaction. For example, urease enzyme, it can only catalyze the hydrolysis of urea. Okay, so this is known as the absolute specificity of the enzyme. Second one is group specificity. It is also suggested by the name group. It means some enzymes which can catalyze a group of reactions. Okay, for example, hexokinase. So hexokinase is an enzyme which catalyzes the all type of hexose sugar. Okay, the third one property is known as bond specificity. So here it means some enzyme can identify the particular bonds, or they can catalyze only at a particular bonding site. For example, ribozymes. Okay, so ribozymes, they catalyze the they do the hydrolysis of phosphodiester bonds. Okay, it means they catalyze the hydrolysis of phosphodiester bonds at 3' end of the pyrimidine bases. At the 3' end, generally हमें पता है डीएनए का स्ट्रक्चर आपने पढ़ा है या कोई भी है 3 या 5 एंड होते हैं, तो इसका मेन फंक्शन क्या होता है राइबोसोम्स का, ये हाइड्रोलिसिस करता है सिर्फ फॉस्फोडाइएस्टर बॉन्ड्स की, और वो भी 3' एंड पे जो प्रेजेंट होते हैं सिर्फ उनकी। ओके, द फोर्थ टाइप ऑफ स्पेसिफिसिटी इज स्टीरियो स्पेसिफिसिटी। सो इट मीन दे कैन ओनली कैटलाइज द स्टीरियो टाइप ऑफ सम सब्सट्रेट। Okay, it means they having the different structure or the arrangement should be in a different manner. So they can only catalyze the stereo type or stereo isomers of some substrate. Okay, for example, amino acid oxidase, which catalyze the reactions through the L amino acids, not by the D amino acids. So these are the stereotypes of one another, and they can only catalyze the L amino acids, not D amino acids. Okay, so this is about the another property of enzyme, specificity. Okay, I hope it is clear to you. Let's go on the next property, colloidal nature. So enzymes having the high molecular weight. Okay, colloidal, due to the colloidal nature, as enzymes are consist of protein, so they are having the high molecular weight. Okay, and due to which they provide large surface area. Is it clear? Okay, and they can catalyze the large number of reactions. Larger in size, as they are consist of protein which having the very large size, so even the small amount of protein can catalyze the large number of reactions. Amphoteric in nature, protein ke hai, it means they can show both acidic and basic nature. Okay, so they are amphoteric in nature. Enzyme optima, it is a very important point, enzyme optima. It means it is a stage okay, where the enzyme can perform their optimum activities. For that, they needed some specific conditions. What is the temperature, pH, concentration of the substrate and products, etc. So this is also a very important property of the enzyme, enzyme optima. It means they perform their optimum activities at some specific or under some specific conditions. Last one is enzyme inhibition. देखिए, it means inhibition to stop or to reduce the activities of the enzymes. So it can be also reduced due to the presence of some substrate which are resemble to the cofactors or which are competitive inhibitors. Okay, so inhibition, it means to stop or to reduce the activity of the enzymes. Okay, so these are the important properties of the enzymes. Understand that they are protein in nature, specificity, colloidal nature, large size, amphoteric nature, enzyme optima, enzyme inhibition. Okay students, so like, comment and share the video, subscribe also. Have a good day. Goodbye.